gonna...
What's the satisfaction of holding a gun in your hand when you could be holding a hoe, planting seeds in a peasant village?
Keep your hoes and seeds to yourself. We don't need gun control. If you read the Constitution, it's a sacred document that should not be changed. Under our Constitution, women couldn't vote, but the liberals come in crying crocodile tears. We need to get scaremongers and non-believers, men like you, Chavez, under control. I've got a good mind to have your funding removed.
We don't get any funding.
Yeah, exactly. Well, good. You won't see a penny out of me. You've got to stop spreading these lies or I'll whip you myself. I'm not afraid. The Constitution asserts a man's right to bear arms and arm bears and all points in between. Whoever heard of a gun or a bear causing problems? This is all cocky pop or whatever that word is. It keeps the place safe. Trouble is caused by unemployment, and unemployment comes from poor economic performance and lazy people. If you had a job, would you steal a car? Of course not. And if you had a high-rise condo, a mistress, and a seat on the board, would you run around graffitiing your name all over town and making a nuisance of yourself, spinning on your back and popping and locking and... Not a hope. It's simple. If you don't have a job, starve. Get out of my constituency. By force...
City Soul Paradise with me, Manning of Wheels of Steel. Get yourself some tea and meat. And if you're listening out there, Siobhan, you best let old Lady Killer out of the doghouse. Cause he's ready to freak on your squeak box, baby.
Fever.
You got the fever.
Patronize and demean the working man. I mean, what kind of right-minded youth from a poorer background is going to spend his time stealing things and posing in silly clothes when he could be getting ahead with a minimum wage job and making his parent proud? The dream of America is to live in a duplex and share a yard. Why would anyone want to threaten that great future? Answer me that and I'll show you a green dog.
And speaking for the underdog, the foundation I set up with my trust fund, we believe gangs are a valid expression of a people's identity, a grouping, a community within a community. Gangs are a way to be noticed in the boxy suburbs. You scream out, rather than urinate at the edge of your camp like a...
Hell, you'll want to whip some ass because you'll be fighting fit.
You'll learn how to argue with officials, beat up enormous men, break legs, and lose weight, especially in the brain. BJ's Fit for Football, out now on Beta and VHS. Remember, to win the game of football or life, you have to annihilate everything in your path in a blind rage.
More mood swings than your pregnant wife. Emotion. 98.3.
Hello, I am Fernando Martinez, and this is Emotion. When I first come to Vice City, I feel all lonely. A man on the outside, a foreigner. Then I say, Fernando, you like to talk a lot? So I get a well-paid job on the radio and begin to make my name as a successful DJ. Now I'm not so lonely, but I never forget my roots. I never forget, and so I always have a soft spot for foreigner. I've been waiting this next.
Stretch limo sunroof, you want to know your hair is performing to the limit. With Sissy Spritz, it's hair for the future, not the past. When you have great hair, people know you're a winner. Sissy Spritz may cause dry mouth, dilated pupils, paranoia, heart palpitations, and nosebleeds, but your hair will be great.
We have some sad news for you.
Rock and roll is dead and pop is in. Why not discover the excitement of the science of music yourself at Synth & Son, the home of keyboards. Thanks to the science of music, you don't need musical talent to make great music. Just listen. I created that just by pressing a button. Synthesizers are the new wave. Why work hard on difficult compositions when a machine can make music better than you've ever dreamed of? You'll be the hit of the party. It's perfect for in-restaurant entertainment, cover bands, and funerals. Make Fuse funky and death marches danceable. It's the science of music at Synth & Son. Remember, you don't know you're a musician until you try.
Anything by now is that money is a good thing. Only the people without it complain. Anyway, I digress, and as a great man once told me, nobody likes a wordsmith. Let's get to the records. Next up, we have an American act for you. They've been around for a few years now, and for my money, this is their finest hour. Atomic by, of course, Blondie.
Oh shit, here we go again.
Emotion 24/7, not just once a month.
Oh, Max, we go every...
It's non-stop rap attack on your radio. Pirate radio. Wild style radio. Now stay tuned for the two live crew giving it all they got. Super Rocky, Mr. Magic, holding it. Washington Beach on a check-in. Can't forget Ocean Beach, they're in the house. Pond Island in the house. The whole damn city's in Mr. Magic's house. Apart from Starfish Island where the crabs live. Definitely not keeping it moving. The place to be is on Wild Style Pirate Radio with me, Super Rocky Mr. Magic. City.
Serrated blade that can kill him.
But you got to get down, 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 down. Even if you stay at home. Make love and listen to some music. You got to let yourself go, 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 girl. You work all week long. You work your fingers to the bone. Fridays at an evening.
Thank you, guys. So, we're back on Pressing Issues. Just one of many fine shows you'll hear if you have the patience to listen to public radio. Although, thanks to the many awards we have won, Pressing Issues has extended playtime and is the number one rated show in the Vice City area. I'm your very entertaining host, Maris Chavez, a man climbing the broadcasting ladder at a rate of 6 knots. 6 years ago, I was a clown, and now I'm a success. Think about it. Imagine where I could be in 10 years. I could achieve anything. Anyway, morality. What is it? Why do we need it? Our ancestors, shortly after discovering fire, built tools to beat each other over the head and discover how to make meat to celebrate with afterwards. Then Columbus came over, shut down the Pilgrim discos. Why? All very confusing if you ask me. And you did. And I asked myself, that is a perfect subject for a region-wide discussion show. Which is very lucky because I happen to host one. To discuss the subject of morality, we have firebrand preacher Pastor Richards, the head of the Pastor Richards Salvation Statue Organization, a group which plans to raise enough money to build a statue of Pastor Richards himself. We also have John Brown, leader of Moms Against Popular Culture, or MAPC. Or is it MAPS? MAPK? I don't know. We're deep in acronym hell right now, or is it purgatory? And finally, we have Barry Stark, author of the book, As Nature Intended. He's the editor of Vice City's Naturist News, and is working feverishly, it says here, to bring more nude recreation to Vice City. To protect the dignity of our other panelists, we place Mr. Barry Stark behind a divider.
I'm naked back here. It's my right as a person.
Yes. Let's start with the obvious, yes? Is it moral to be naked?
Yes! You can't stop me!
Well, I'm a mother, so I have to deal with this issue every day. My adorable kids have learned that it's wrong to be naked. When it's bath time, they know to put on a bathing costume. That's also the reason there are no mirrors in my house. Nudity leads to bad, naughty things.
Maurice, if I may interrupt, I haven't worn clothes since 1982. Clothes are seriously unnatural. Didn't you guys learn anything from the 60s? I had a revelation when I was on holiday in Germany. I'd always felt very constricted. Then it hit me like a slippery fish. Clothes are plain wrong. When you're born, you're not wearing any clothes. When you die, you're not wearing any clothes.
I'm going to have to interrupt you there. What if you die at work? What if an enormous piece of machinery falls on you while you're working?
Clothes lead to immorality. Nudity stops people from fighting. Have you seen an issue of National Geographic lately? People around the world are nude. You don't want to shoot a machine gun or a howitzer or a flamethrower if you're naked. It could burn or scald in quite a personal fashion, quite frankly. Have you been to the zoo? Animals are naked. If everyone were naked, there'd be no war. Everyone's complaining about crime and the theft of cars in the city. No one's ever stolen my car. No one's ever pickpocketed me. They've never even tried.
That's because you're a degenerate loony.
If the police were naked, it would set a great example to everyone. You can direct traffic and eat donuts entirely in the buff.
Maurice, this kind of immoral behavior is exactly why I'm building the Pastor Richard Salvation statue. Noah had an ark, Texans had the Alamo, and I am building a highly fortified structure in my image. Simple. This 50-story statue will be able to deflect alpha, gamma, and beta radiation. The day is coming, and coming soon, where the artificial suns will rain down to punish the degenerates of this city. But you can save yourself. The Pastor Richard Salvation statue will be a completely self-sufficient community. We have canned food rations, private living quarters, and enough supplies to survive happily the predicted 40,000 years of nuclear winter. In phase two, and with funding from NASA, we will equip this massive statue with rockets. So when the poopy hits the proverbial fan, we will load up the statue with all of the people who have saved themselves through generous donations, blast into space, and colonize Saturn with a race of morally correct, affluent people ruled by me.
Will there be naked people?